गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर वन ऑफ यूनिट वन, दैट इज बेसिस ऑफ कंप्यूटर। कंप्यूटर इज द मोस्ट पावरफुल एंड वर्सटाइल टूल एवर क्रिएटेड बाय ह्यूमन बींग्स, एंड दिस क्रिएशन इन्फ्लुएंस आवर लाइफ इन मेनी वेज। वी यूज कंप्यूटर इन डिफरेंट सेक्टर फॉर द डिफरेंट पर्पसेज, सच एज इन एजुकेशन सेक्टर वी यूज कंप्यूटर्स फॉर द एजुकेशन और फॉर इंफॉर्मेशन और नॉलेज। इन बैंकिंग सेक्टर कंप्यूटर्स आर यूज फॉर बैंकिंग एंड मोर फॉर द अदर पर्पसेज इन डिफरेंट सेक्टर्स। कम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजीज आर ऑल्सो नोन एज टेलीकम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजीज, एंड दिस टेक्नोलॉजी हेल्प अस इन कम्युनिकेटिंग ओवर लॉन्ग डिस्टेंसेज विद द हेल्प ऑफ सम इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक डिवाइसेज सच एज टेलीफोन, मोबाइल, रेडियो, ब्रॉडकास्ट टेलीविजन, केबल टीवी, ब्रॉडबैंड एंड मेनी मोर डिवाइसेज वी यूज इन कम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजीज। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट इज द मेजर डिफरेंस बिटवीन इंफॉर्मेशन एंड कम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजी एंड इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। इंफॉर्मेशन एंड कम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजी ऑल्सो वी रेफर्ड एज ICT। In information and communication technology, we produce, manipulate and store information for high speed communication with the help of some electromagnetic devices and computers, in which information can be carried out from one source to some destination. For example, when we go online and browse for something through our PC or mobile smartphones, we need a communication path, that is our internet services, and we also need some electromagnetic device such as modem or broadband to access any information. But in information technologies, we study design or develop and implement the information that is carried throughout the computer system. It means that we study about the computer system, how computer can accept an input, give the output, what are the processes that computers implement. We study all the functions and all the works of the computer system. Now the question is, what is a computer system? A computer system is an electronic device which accept, store and process the instructions that are given by the user. An instruction is a set of code or set of programs that are given to the computer system. A computer system consists of two components, hardware and software component, such as keyboard, mouse, speaker are the hardware components, whereas operating system, device managers, some application programs such as Microsoft Office, PowerPoint are the software components of a computer system. These hardware and software components are further classified into input devices, output devices and storage devices. Now we are going to discuss some characteristics of a computers. First one is automatic. When we assign a particular job or a multiple job to a computer system, it start working and automatically it stop when the job is done without the help of any users. But before assigning a job to the computer system, we need to start the computer system by the users. Now speed. As we know that computer system can process any information at enormous high speed, and they are also capable of taking logical decision, performing arithmetic and non-arithmetic operations. A powerful computer system can perform 3 to 4 million arithmetic operations within a second. Computer system operates on electrical signals that is known as electric pulse. Accuracy. As we know that computer system always gives an accurate result, but sometimes it may be not correct, and this mistake is not done by the computer system. This mistake is caused by some human errors, such as some logical error during the program development, or some inadequate or improper data are provided to the computer system. Computer systems are also very versatile. Versatile means can able to do multiple jobs at a time or perform multiple tasks at a same time. A computer system accept data and produce result, perform some arithmetic and logical operations, and transfer data at a same time. So versatility is one of the main features of computer system. Diligence means capable of performing the same task over and over again with the same degree of accuracy and reliability without getting tired. As humans, after a particular time, we get tired of doing something, but computer never get tired. It continuously work for long time. Large and perfect memory. As a human being, our ability to acquire and retain knowledge is limited, but a computer can store and recall any amount of information. This is because of the large storage capacity of a computer system. When a computer system needs some information, it retrieves from the storage device. But computer system also have some limitations, such as computer system doesn't have any IQ. They doesn't have any feeling, such as humans. Computer system does not have the ability of thinking as humans. We can think about something. Computer system does not take any decision. They perform only those tasks that are determined by the user, because they don't have decision making ability as human beings. Since the computer is a machine, it has not know any hard or soft feeling about something or anything. Moving forward, we are going to see classification of a computer system. A computer system can be classified on the basis of historical development, purpose, technology use, size and capacity. On the basis of historical development, a computer system can be classified into 5 categories. First one, first generation computer, second generation computer, third generation computer, fourth generation computer, and fifth generation computer. The computer system that are developed a time period of 1942 to 1955 are categorized as first generation computer. Some basic components of first generation computers are vacuum tube, electromagnetic relay memory, punch card, secondary storage memory. Basic software used are machine and assembly language, stored program concepts, mostly scientific applications. They are bulky in size, highly unreliable. They are also costly and difficult to use. Some examples of first generation computers are ENIAC. Some examples of first generation computers are ENIAC, EDVAC, EDSAC, UNIVAC 1, IBM 701. Second generation computer time period is from 1955 to 1964. And the basic components of second generation computers are transistor, magnetic core memory, magnetic tape, and disk secondary storage. Software used are batch operating system, high level programming language, scientific and commercial applications. They are more faster, smaller, and more reliable than the first generation computer. But second generation computers are also costly and difficult to use. Some examples of second generation computers are Honeywell 400, IBM 7030, CDC 1604, UNIVAC, LARC. The time period of third generation computers are 1964 to 1975. Basic components are ICs, which means integrated circuits with SSI. SSI means small scale integration, and MSI technologies. Larger magnetic core memory, larger capacity magnetic disk and tapes, secondary storage devices and mini computers. Software used are time-sharing operating system, standardization of high-level programming language, unbundling of software from hardware. They are faster, smaller, and more reliable, easier and cheaper to produce, commercial and easy to use than the previous generation computer system. Some basic examples of third generation computer systems are IBM 360 and 370, PDP 8, PDP 11, CDC 6600. The time period of fourth generation computer system are 1975 to 1989. Components are ICs with VLC, VLSI technology, microprocessor, semiconductor memory, large capacity hard disk, magnetic tapes and floppy disk as portable storage media. The software used are operating system for PC. GUI means graphic user interface, multiple windows on a single terminal screen, Unix operating systems, C programming, C++ programming and many more. They are smaller, affordable and reliable than the previous generation computer system, and they are also easy to use. Personal computers are referred into the fourth generation computer system. Some examples of fourth generation computer systems are IBM PC and its clone, Apple II, TRS-80, VAX 9000, Cray 1, Cray 2, Cray X. The time period of fifth generation computer systems are from 1989 to present till present. The components used in fifth generation computer systems are IC used with ULSI technology, larger capacity main memory, larger capacity hard disk, optical disk. The software used are World Wide Web, multimedia applications, internet-based applications. Some features of fifth generation computers are they are portable computers, more powerful, cheaper, reliable, and easy to use. Some examples of fifth generation computers are IBM notebooks, Pentium PCs, Sun workstations, SGI Origin,